What is up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Devin, and today I want to talk to you guys about 5 tips to help you get more professional looking footage out of your drone. So let's get into it. The first tip that I want to share with you guys is to learn how to shoot in manual mode. Learning to shoot manually in the camera settings instead of just relying on auto mode is going to open up your world so much and give you way more flexibility to get creative shots using your drone. So what does it mean to shoot manually? What that typically means is that you're manually dialing in your shutter speed, your ISO, and your aperture. Some drones let you select and adjust your aperture. You can dial it in from f2.8 to f11 or whatever it might be on your drone. But what I've learned is that a lot of times most people leave them in the sharpest setting that they found to be in f2.8 or f4. Now on other drones, you've got a fixed aperture. Like on the Mavic Air 2 here, it's got a fixed aperture of f2.8. So good news there is that that might be one less thing for you to worry about dialing in when shooting manually on your drone. Next up is dialing in your shutter speed. In the video world, dialing in your shutter speed all depends on what your frame rate is that you are shooting in. Now, what frame rate you should shoot in is totally up to you. That's more of a creative decision on your part. So if you want things to be in real time, then shoot in 24 or 30 frames per second. If you want some slow motion, shoot in 60 frames per second or higher. And from there, you can dial in your shutter speed using whatever frame rate you have. So your shutter speed should always be double your frame rate or as close as possible to it as you can. So for example, if you are shooting at 30 frames per second, you should have a shutter speed of 1/60th of a second. What that is referred to in the video world is the 180 degree rule. And that gives it that cinematic professional look to your shot. Now a higher shutter speed is also gonna eat up your light. So think about that. And when you are setting up your frame rate and shutter speed, a later time of day or when there's lower light condition, you probably won't or don't want to shoot with a high frame rate. So if you're in a lower light situation and you need all the light you can get, have a slower shutter speed. So maybe shoot at 24 or 30 frames per second and have a shutter speed around 50 to 60, and that's gonna give you more light. Maybe we'll get into that in another video, but those are the baselines you wanna do. Just remember, double your frame rate. All right, and then also when shooting manually, don't forget to set your ISO. Don't leave that on auto because the camera will select whatever it thinks is best, and it may do a fine job, but let's go ahead and set that manually, and that way it's not changing on you mid-shot. And basically, you always wanna keep your ISO as low as possible. Now, what is ISO? ISO is the sensitivity of light to your sensor. So what that means is the higher the ISO number, the more light that it's gonna be letting in. And I always try to set my ISO to 100. And then if needed, I will bump it up to 200, 300, and in a pinch, even 400. Now, after you go higher than that in ISO on these drones and these sensors, and same thing on GoPros, is you're gonna start to introduce more and more noise as it tries to allow more light and sensitivity to your sensor. So just keep your ISO as low as possible. All right, the next tip that I have for you guys is learn to read your histogram. Now, what your histogram does, and you can turn that on in your settings, is it basically gives a visual representation of the exposure of your scene. It's gonna basically show whether it's overexposed or underexposed. And it shows you a graph, and it kind of looks like a bunch of mountains. And what you wanna do is not have all the information spiking on one side, and you want all the information to be somewhere right in the middle. That means that you have a pretty balanced shot and it's gonna give you the best results. Now, depending on what you're shooting, you may want it one side or the other, but just learn how to read it, because what can happen is it might look great on your phone. Maybe you've got an extremely bright phone or tablet that you are filming from and viewing the footage, but then when you get back to the computer, you're like, oh, that's a little underexposed, or maybe that was a little overexposed. And then you're gonna have to spend time editing and try to fix that, and hopefully you can. But learning how to use your histogram and reading it will help you dial in those shots and get the shot you're looking for the first time. All right, the next tip that I have for you guys is shoot in a flat color profile. Shooting flat is gonna give you the most dynamic range so that when you do get back to the computer and start editing your footage, you can make it look exactly how you want to. So this means shooting in D-Cine-like or a D-Log profile, anything as flat as possible. Now I have another video that I hook you guys up with some free corrective LUTs and color profile packs. So I will link that in the description below as well. Hopefully that will help you get started when shooting on a flat color profile and get awesome looking footage. So I've got a whole other video on this subject alone, but my next tip is to make smooth movements. Try not to make your viewers sick with fast or jittery movements. I like to keep my movements simple, slow, and smooth. Now, if you're flying FPV drones or different things like that where you need fast movements, then that's what it calls for. But for most things, I find that a slow, gentle movements, don't be rough on the joysticks, is gonna give you nice cinematic looking footage. So what about when you have your frame rate selected, you have your ISO as low as possible, and your shutter speed is dialed in where you need it, but now your image is still too bright, and you don't wanna overcrank, you want that nice motion blur. Well, that is where the next tip that I have for you guys comes in, and that is to use ND filters. What ND filters are gonna do for you is help control the light entering in through your lens to your sensor. Now, I was super lucky because Freewell hooked me up with some ND and ND polarizers in this all day pack, and it's been awesome. You've got all the stuff that you need to cover yourself for all day. So no matter what I'm shooting, my footage can look how I want it to look, and these things have been perfect. So definitely invest in some ND filters. That'll help you dial in your camera settings and get the footage that you're looking for. And one bonus tip for you guys, shoot at the pretty part of the day. Shoot either early morning or late evening, the last hour or the first hour of the day, known as golden hour. You're gonna get awesome contrast, great colors, and it's just beautiful to shoot during golden hour. All right, guys, well, that is it for this video. I hope that you guys enjoyed. If you learned something and got anything out of this video, please leave this video a thumbs up. It really helps my channel out. Comment down below, let me know what you guys think, and I will see you guys in the next video.